As a dancer myself, I was wondering what your favourite parts and aspects of dance were and how you've sort of brought it to your acting.
Well, because I'd lost my mother and I was yearning for that female contact, I was very good at pas de deux. You know, my, and this is, I'll make this comparison. There was one other guy that I danced alongside at the Stedfords, and he was very mechanical, but very good, technically very good. But to this day, and he ended up in the Australian Ballet Company, you know, as a principal dancer, and his technical side of it is just amazing to watch him, you know. But I knew I could feel, and I knew my difference between him and me was when I was with somebody, if it was the expressions. And that's why I ended up sort of jumping out of dancing into the acting realm, for better or for worse. I don't know, you know, like there's elements of every art form. I think if you choose, it's got its pros and cons, but you know, the dancing, I mean, I loved it. I was never more fit and healthy than when I was doing my dancing. That was just, you know. But the girl that I used to dance with, her name was Jane Finney. I went on to become a principal dancer for the Australian Ballet as well. So if I'd stuck at it, I probably could have got there. But, you know, I got from it what I needed at the time. It was the thing that gave me 2 or 3 years of dancing with female energy, you know, and that helped me get through that time that I was going through with the loss of my mother. Yeah. Plus, it's a little bit like the Black Swan, my studio. we had some pretty bitchy ballet mums and some pretty interesting scenarios going on that I kind of went, I don't know whether I can stay in this confined space for so many hours every day with this going on, but maybe that was just my studio.